time. Each foreign affairs crisis or each problem counts in the election, the points up, points down, and I'm sure it's going to go this way until we reach the election date on November 6th. But at the same time, it's also a setback because I think that President Obama's administration was putting a lot of hopes on President Morsi's reaching office and becoming a popularly elected government in terms of maintaining the same strategic ties that existed between Egypt and the United States over the past over 30 years, and at the same time proving that the Muslim Brotherhood as a political Islamic group can maintain the same sort of balance in the relations that existed in terms of being a U.S. ally, in terms of not causing embarrassment for the U.S. government, because for the average American citizen, when he sees on TV that his embassy is being raided, and again in a country that's supposed to be an ally, and the flag being burned, this definitely doesn't reflect very well on our side of the relationship. And I think that there are now more pressures on President Obama, perhaps to reconsider how he's been dealing positively with the political Islamic groups, because in their view, at least, they were not able to contain the more extremist elements who were basically chanting very much.
Yes, and that was very much indeed reflected in his response to what's what
indeed happened. It's a very important when he said that they are not allies and they are not from enemies.
Definitely.
At the same time, it's a change of policy. They tried to contain it later, saying it's not a major thing. They tried to put it as a technical term because Egypt is not a NATO ally, but I'm sure that you've been following Egypt-US relations for long, and we always maintain that strategic partner status. That's not what the U.S. president said.
Both American and Egyptian relationship will always be very strategic, as you said, you know, and no way that we can take that away from both countries. Means that whatever happened, like last week in the embassy, is not going by any means to harm the American relationship with Egypt. Why? Because it's the interest of Egypt, the interest of America and the same time American administration. However, I want to pay your attention, as well I want to say to all the Egyptians that I lived in the United States, so I know the American people quite well. American people in general, they love Egypt so much, and through my business, when American people come to Egypt, you know, they consider it their home.
Well, they loved the Egypt.
They love Pharaonic Egypt, I think,
now,
more than anything else.
But now with an Islamist rise, I mean here an Islamist regime taking the authority, and in light of what they have seen, so I kind of doubt now the
I can tell you right now, if you happen to know the American people, and you know that, of course, who they are reading anyway, but the American people, they honor every single religion, whatever you have.
Because the Americans are religious people by themselves.
And so in the same time, that takes me to prove to you, it is well respected. Our religion is well respected by the American people. But you have to know that the American people don't have, they didn't know that much about Egypt. I would say they should know us through our own activities. Means our ambassador there, our people, our TV, our media, you know, our movies. These all elements to show the other people what Egypt is, what are the Egyptian people.
Exactly.
You know, I mean,
you mean here
that's a long-term strategy.
What I was just saying to Dr. Saeed, activities of the associations or the Egyptian expatriates who are living there, what are they exactly doing?
And they have to know what's Islam. You know, everybody now, they know Islam is the beard, Islam is the big guys, Islam is a threat to them. You know, Islam is not. As a matter of fact,
Islam is those who committed the 9/11 attacks.
Exactly, very peaceful. You know, I mean, but we have this problem here in Egypt. You know, attacks here and there, and after even or during the revolution, many things happen. Are we going in that Islam? Are we going to withdraw away from Islam? Because these people, that's a group of people. The same thing happened in last week.
Radicals. This they is are one radicals, radical figures. Yes.
Exactly.
The
unfortunately,
exactly.
But we have to be very, very realistic, Doctor. Of course, I fully agree with you. I mean, but we're not preaching ourselves for the
exactly.
average
exactly.
American citizen. And as, of course, Mona mentioned, you know, exactly. the 9/11 attacks. Mm. I went to the States immediately, like 1 year, almost less than 1 year after the 9/11 attacks, and it remains to be a lively memory, and then many incidents afterwards
exactly.
come.
Yeah.
And it doesn't make sense for, again, the yeah. average American citizen who doesn't know a lot about
exactly.
the Middle East.
Yeah,
if he repeatedly, what do you hear about the Middle East? What do you hear coming out from the region? A suicide attack here, a suicide attack there, and plus, that I think we have to admit that I think the reaction to the film
yes.
being a privately produced movie, it's
yes.
not
it's not
US
the government,
government
yeah.
money. The U.S.
Yeah.
did not donate the like
I
sort
agree.
Of support it directly or indirectly. That we overreacted, that we
exactly.
probably were demonstrating in
exactly.
front of the relatively wrong place. It's
right.
not the,
I
mean, the embassy represents the U.S. government
exactly.
and not the cinema industry in California where
yeah.
yes.
yeah.
this
where
takes me exactly to what we are speaking about today and the military presence. Now, some of the political observers said that such a film, and I'm sorry to say,
I don't
was
even
revealed.
Call it a film. It's a
trailer.
It's
whatever.
A cheap production.
Exactly. It is definitely by all means. Some of the political observers said that such a film was revealed or made or published in these days specifically. Right ahead of the U.S. elections and to extend a U.S. military presence in the country.
And on 9/11. And also
on the 9/11 attack, but I don't think so. Why? Because if you follow the Obama administration tendency since he took office, he wants to pull back from whatever the U.S. or his former
yes.
administration, W. Bush administration, got the U.S. involved. He pulled out most of the 90% of the U.S. troops out of Iraq. He set a deadline for the withdrawal of the U.S. troops from Afghanistan, supposedly by 2014. And, I mean, again, I want to use my experience working as a correspondent for Aham in Washington. The members or the elements who produced these films and worked on those films, they've always been trying to do incidents like this.
Mm-hmm.
When I was there, it used to surprise me. Every single small incident that happens here in Egypt involving a Muslim and a Christian
exactly.
or something becomes a big deal. And
exactly.
they go, they
exactly.
meet Congress members, they make
yes.
Meetings. They say things that are full of hate. I think, in my opinion,
congressmen and senators,
of
yes.
course, and unfortunately, some of
yes.
the Egyptians who live
yeah.
abroad. I
yes.
mean, we have to admit them. But I want to stress here, Mona, and let me say this again as a testimony that the elements, the Egyptian minority Christian elements, who are living in the States and taking this very sort of hatred
they
line,
are
they are a minority.
Mm.
They are a super minority, and they're not even accepted. That like someone like Maurice Sadiq. Someone like, you know, Basili, Joseph, all these guys, they cannot even go to the Egyptian churches that are run by the Coptic Orthodox Church.
And
they
are many question marks on those
extremists,
figures.
You know, I mean, they are not representative. And it's like, I think, again, we blew the thing out of proportion. And in my view, the best way to deal with those kinds of films, articles here and there, is simply ignore them.
Yeah.
Make those people feel what they are worth, that
exactly.
you are worth this.
Yeah.
So
and
when you do something like this, we should not really take it
I just
Doctor,
very
yes.
much
yes.
seriously.
Let me ask you, you
okay.
have mentioned very important thing, which is the strategic relationship between the U.S. and Egypt.
Mm.
This strategic relations comes from the mutual interests of both
yes.
sides here. why do you think this relation should continue and preserved?
Because
for the sake of the United States and the same for Egypt.
Yeah, because we need United States as a government. It's the strong. It's the strongest power on earth. We need it as Egypt. We need the help of the experts in whatever field.
Mm.
We need their education. We need
technology.
Their technology, their financial support as well. So we need the United States. Why the United States need us?
Yes.
Because Egypt, you know, the position of Egypt as geography is concerned, you cannot deny it. I mean, we are almost in the best position, can tie up the whole world. You know, so United States needs it. Now, two, we are the leader, no matter if any other country try
to take our
to place. Take over a position that will never happen. Could Egypt back up is big and huge civilization.
We have yet to return to this rule you're speaking about.
Exactly. I love that.
But we have a lot of influence. I mean, whether or not history or not, but the United States recognized very well that Egypt has this central position
As a leader.
With acceptable governments to the nations,
yes, you know, with the leader, as a leader in the area, especially in Middle East. And the truth is that all the Arab countries, they know in their heart, the people, I mean, Egypt is the leading of their society, of Arab society. You know what I mean? So sometimes they even do not accept, do not believe their own countries, but believe Egypt being the leader, you know? That's a situation.
I fully agree. And there are also other elements like the Israel element, the Syria element, the Iran element.
Middle. And we can play a big role in many areas.
Of course, we're very significant
that
in this.
That brings me to this in between lines threat that President Obama gave here when he said, if we do not maintain our relations or our peace agreement with Israel, if we do not protect the United States interests in the in Egypt, and also if we do not protect the diplomatic missions, then there will be problems. And I guess he hinted here at the U.S. aid.
The U.S. military aid and the U.S. economic aid. I've always seen the U.S. military aid and the U.S. economic aid.